So today we are going to discuss salmonellosis, and as we know, salmonellosis is caused by the various, you can say, serotypes of the salmonella, and this salmonella belongs to the family Enterobacteriaceae, and the name salmonella actually, you can say, given on by as per the name of first discoverer, that is D. Salmon, and who has Salmonella oldrasuis from the pig in 1885. As on the morphology basis, Salmonella is a, you can say, gram-negative rod-shaped bacteria, or it has also non-spore-forming capability. Mainly, it is a motile organism, with exceptions of, you can say, Salmonella gallinarum and Salmonella pullorum. All other Salmonella, you can say, motile organism. With you can say, motility of Salmonella is governed by Peritrichus, you can say, flagella. Currently, there are two species of, you can say, Salmonella. One is the Salmonella enterica, and other is the Salmonella bungori. Other names you know, that are either, you can say, called as serotype or serovars of the Salmonella. So let us see. So there are till date about more than 2650 serovars of or serotypes of the Salmonella are reported, and serotyping of Salmonella mainly performed as per, you can say, Kaufman and White scheme. So you must study in microbiology in detail. So out of these, according to this Kaufman and Whiteman scheme, Salmonella enterica have 2639 serovars, and you can say Salmonella bungori constituted by the 20 serovars. And the basis of this serotyping is based on, you can say, OH and VI, that is antigens, and accordingly Salmonella enterica subspecies enterica. So actually Salmonella enterica, again the species Salmonella enterica have six different subspecies. One of the subspecies is Salmonella enterica subspecies enterica. Out of these two species, Salmonella bungori are generally considered as non-pathogenic, and most of the pathogenic serovars or serotypes comes under the Salmonella enterica species. So Salmonella enterica subspecies, that is enterica, have about 1586 serotypes, of which mainly the most important, you can say, genotic Salmonella, that is the Salmonella typhimurium and Salmonella enteritidis, comes under the Salmonella enterica subspecies enterica. Likewise, other Salmonella subspecies includes Salami erigeni, Dai erigeni, Hortinei, Indica. These are others, you can say, subspecies of Salmonella enterica, and in, you can say, in bracket, it's there is, you can say, different serotypes reported till date are given. So Salmonella bungori, these all Salmonella, you can say, subtypes are designated with the Roman numerals 1 to 6. Previously Salmonella bungori designated by which is the Roman numeral 5, and again this composed of about 22 serotypes. And each Salmonella bungori mainly associated with the cold-blooded animals. Role in human infections are very uncommon, but sometimes it's reported that it may be the children of 1 month to 3 year of age. But generally, it is considered as Salmonella bungori. ये बंद कर लो, म्यूट कर लो माइक को. श्रुति माइक को म्यूट कर लो. सो यू हैव टू नो हाउ वी कैन राइट द नेम ऑफ द आइदर जीनस और स्पेसीज और सब स्पेसीज और देयर सिरोवर. सो जस्ट यू गो विद द एग्जांपल्स. सो हियर रिटन इन एग्जांपल साल्मोनेला एंटेरिका सब स्पेसीज एंटेरिका सिरोटाइप टाइफिमुरियम. So Here, Salmonella is the genus. Enterica is the species. Subspecies again is the Enterica, and its serotype or serovar is Typhimurium. So, in short forms, we can write their name as Salmonella Typhimurium. But there is one restriction. You have not to underline or italic. The species name must not be written either in italic forms or underlined. So simply you have to write the species serovar names, you can say, by the first letter caps, just like genus name starts with the first letter caps. So here serovar names also written with first letter caps without, you can say, underline or italic. So shortly we can write Salmonella Typhimurium, Salmonella enteritidae, Salmonella gallinarum, Salmonella pullorum, Salmonella, you can say, Worthington, Erigoni, that is the subspecies. So now sources, what are the sources of, you can say, Salmonella, and what are the different modes of their transmissions? So Salmonella serovars are mainly isolated from the wide range of animals and their food products, and that may include the poultry, bovine, porcine, fish, cepids, poikilothermic animals, that is the cold-blooded animals such as lizard and snakes. And the infections, Salmonella again may categorize into two, either non-typhoidal Salmonella or typhoidal Salmonella. Non-typhoidal Salmonella are mainly either host adopted or non-host adopted. So host adopted means that Salmonella serovars, you can say, that recognized to cause disease in a specific host. Just for example, Salmonella gallinarum, it's known to cause disease in poultry. Non-host adopted Salmonella Typhimurium, Salmonella Typhimurium, Salmonella enteritidae, they are known to cause disease, or you can say, in any of the life, like you can say farm animals, human beings, or you can say even these poikilothermic animals or fish or likewise. So host adopted and non-host adopted, we can divide the non-typhoidal Salmonella. So its infections may you got by the ingestion of the contaminated food with the Salmonella bacteria, just like egg, chicken, beef, pork, milk products, fruits and vegetables. Mainly you can say by the ingestions of the improperly cooked or you can say post-spring contaminated food. So direct person-to-person contacts are also reported. Contact with the infected animals, that like farm animals or cats or dog, pet animals, rodents, reptiles, amphibians are also reported. Typhoidal Salmonella, mainly under this, only those Salmonella comes out that are, you can say, able to cause typhoid and paratyphoid fever in human beings. So for typhoidal Salmonella, human being acts as a reservoir or host. Only host. So typhoidal Salmonella only affects the human being, and it's mainly transmitted from infected person to healthy person, or person to person transmission through the oral routes. The inadequate sanitations or water hygiene or hand hygiene. So these are certain way of transmission of, you can say, Salmonella, just we discussed previously. So now the disease conditions. Typhoidal Salmonella serovars, that may include Salmonella serovar typhi, Salmonella serovar paratyphi, Salmonella serovar typhi, or Salmonella typhi, we can simply say that's responsible for causing of enteric fever, or that's most commonly known as typhoid fever in human being. Paratyphi, that are responsible for paratyphoid fever. This disease have a incubation period of about 14 days. And this disease is characterized by the various symptoms, that is gradual onset of sustained fever, that is 39 to 40 degrees centigrade, chills, abdominal pain, hepatosplenomegaly, rashes, this is rosy spots on the body, nausea, anorexia, diarrhea, constipation, headache, and sometimes dry cough. Non-typhoidal salmonella, that is also NTS, that is in short form, that's written as NTS, non-typhoidal salmonella, serovars that may cause the disease that are self-limiting and may characterize with acute gastroenteritis and body diarrhea. It has again an incubation period of 6 to 12 hours, which lasts in about 10 days. So its infection may persist up to 10 days from the point of infection. So you may find some symptoms like diarrhea, nausea, vomition, abdominal pain, fever in case of the infections with the non-typhoidal salmonella. But often various non-typhoidal salmonella, salmonella typhimurium and enteritidis are well recognized to cause food poisoning in human beings. In immunocompromised, it also affects severely, or some invasive infections or systemic infections, you can say, may seen in, you can say, most commonly in immunocompromised. Now, disease that you already studied in microbiology, just we see as a glimpse of diseases caused by the salmonella in animals. So, in cattle, it's salmonella is caused by, you can say, salmonella lovelin and salmonella, sometimes salmonella typhimurium. As we know, salmonella is a non-host adopted salmonella. So clinical salmonellosis along with the isolation of other serotypes from the infected animals is considered as a diagnosis of this. In adult, the source of infections mainly are feces and milk of an infected cow. The symptoms that are given here, no need to mug up all things. In swine, and the swine acts as a principal reservoir for salmonella, cholera sois, and you can say in salmonella cholera sois, cause disease conditions in the swine is known as swine paratyphoid or a necrotic interaction. In goats and sheep, mainly in salmonella, you can say the infection of salmonella typhimurium and other serotypes may be seen. Simply the disease conditions characterized by the, you can say, salmonella gastroenteritis, and sometimes salmonella abortus ovis infections that leads to the, you can say, gastroenteritis, abortion in last 2 months of pregnancy, stillbirth, pregnant mortality of the neonates. In, you can say, equine family, the salmonella abortus equi infections most commonly seen, and that may lead to the abortion in 7 to 8 pregnancy, and sometimes male horses or donkey may affected with you can say salmonella abortus by infections that are, you can say, that is, you can say the genital organs are mainly, your reproductive organ, we can say, are mainly affected. In case of dogs and cats, actually dogs and cats are, you can say, acts as asymptomatic carriers for, you can say, salmonellosis. They may get infections by the consumption of the, you can say, fecal material of other animals or men that suffer from the gastroenteritis. In bird, mainly two serovars, that is Salmonella pullorum and Salmonella gallinarum, are most commonly now known to cause disease. And then mainly these birds are actually acts as a host. Other birds, chicken and turkeys, are major host, but other birds like pigeon, quails, ducks, guinea fowl, peafowls may act as a, you can say, host. And however, domestic poultry acts as a, you can say, potent reservoir. And Salmonella pullorum leads to the pullorum disease that mainly affects the younger birds of roughly 2 to 4 months of the age. However, Salmonella gallinarum that leads to the fall typhoid mainly affects the adult birds. Now, disease in animals may continue. We can continue with pullorum diseases. that are characterized by the various, you can say, the symptoms like depression, anorexia, huddling, dropping beings, dehydration, labored breathing, ruffled feathers, etc. Now the diagnosis of the different Salmonella virus infections. So again, the you can say isolation, laboratory isolations, you can say diagnose the disease based on the clinical symptoms, or in laboratory, we can say laboratory isolation and their further identification are called as the gold standard test. So diagnosis of salmonellosis may be performed by the cultural methods or by the performing of the isolation and serotyping of the organisms by the molecular tools. So in cultural methods, as we know, this is considered as the gold standard test. So we can isolate Salmonella from the clinical samples like stool, blood, bone marrow, urine, etc. While fecal and blood samples, while fecal and food source are most common, you can say acts as a sample source for non-typhoidal Salmonella. So for isolation, we perform the three steps. First is the pre-enrichment. Pre-enrichment most commonly performed in buffered peptone water with the inoculation of the, you can say, sample in buffered peptone water with a, you can say, incubation at 37 degrees centigrade for 18 to 24 hours. Here, actually, we can suppose the Salmonella presents in the samples are in very few numbers, and thus pre-enrichment is, you can say, performed to increase in the number of the cells, or you can say also to recover the, you can say, injured cells. Enrichment, again, that is the second steps of isolation of the Salmonella, and most commonly enrichment of samples performed in selenite 16 broth or tetrathionite broth with overnight incubation at 37 degrees centigrade, and various selective media or differential media, we can say, or chromogenic media available. So for selective plating of the, you can say, Salmonella, and most common differential media that is known as McConkie lactose agar or McConkie agar. Others agar are also reported, or you can say reported as selective, you can say, agar or media that's like a hecton enteric agar, xylose lysine deoxycholate agar, Salmonella sigella agar, bismuth sulfite agar, brilliant green agar, and that is chromogenic media like chrome agar. We can see the property on white agar, black colony, HE agar, black color colony, XLD, black color colony, and these black color colony produced by the Salmonella, black centered colony, we can see, produced by the Salmonella AGP, their H2S. And you can say McConkie agar, they produce the pale color colony due to the non-lactose. So biochemical, then after isolation, the colony of the Salmonella may be confirmed by, you can say, various sets of the biochemical tests, and the most common sets of, you can say, identification is the Imbic test. So it produced the result, negative, positive. Imbic test, again, it also gives the results, that is for urease test, that is a negative result in urease test, and that test is most commonly, urease test is most commonly used to differentiate between the Salmonella and Proteus, because both Salmonella and Proteus produces black color colonies in the agar. And TSI, again, that is the sugar iron. And in this TSI slant or agar, you can say it produces slant, you can say acidic but with alkaline slant and with blackening, that is the H2S. In diagnosis, again, the serotyping may be performed, but in India, there are two centers known for serotyping of the Salmonella. The first is the National Salmonella and Escherichia Center, situated at Kasauli, Himachal Pradesh, and second center is the National Salmonella Center, that is situated at IVRI. Next is the molecularly, it may be, you can say, confirmed by the various molecular methods like PCR, that that are, you can say, standardized by for amplifications of the barrier, Salmonella specific gene or Salmonella species specific gene, or you can say Salmonella serovar specific gene. So we have, in our department, we have facility for, you can say, identification of Salmonella genus by amplification of HILA gene, HIS-J gene, INHBE gene, Salmonella identification of Salmonella typhimurium by targeting the TIF-A gene, and Salmonella enteritidis by targeting the INT gene. Likewise, similarly, these organisms may be identified by the use of the various molecular typing methods, and the typing, most common typing methods are reported like PFG, MLST, ribotyping, arbitrarily primed PCR, and other CRISPR. Serological diagnosis, just I told, or that is the Vidal tube agglutination test, that is the most common test we are using for diagnosis of the typhoid group of Salmonella. Others, logical diagnosis, serological testing are ELISA, enzyme immunoassay, PCR based test, already I discussed, and some other techniques like MALDI-TOF, whole genome sequencing are nowadays performed, and say identification of Salmonella. Now, prevention and control. So, Salmonella in animals can be prevented by, you can say, eliminations of the carrier animals, immunization of the carrier animals, proper management of the herd and poultry farms. In human, Salmonella can be, you can say, prevented by reduction its prevalence in food animals. So most common source for transmission of, you can say, non-typhoidal Salmonella is food of animal origin. We can, if the source reduction, then there is definitely a transmission reduction or prevalence takes place. So we have to target the reduction in the, you can, the source of these animals, or reduction in reservoir host or the prevalence in food. Proper inspections or supervisions of the meat, egg, and poultry productions, educations of the farmer, milkers, butcher, animal food handlers about the basic concept of the food hygiene, slaughter hygiene, personal hygiene, as well as environmental hygiene. So, producers and consumers, educations by the, you can say, proper cooking and refrigeration practices, or you can say, to a storage of food. A different cooked food, we can say. Epidemiological surveillance, definitely you can say, to help in prevention and control of this. Thank you.